Hey guys, so welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I want us to talk about spray tanning. If you guys are familiar with it, I have actually talked quite a bit about tanning overall, like self-tanning or just sunless tanning. I've done a self-tanning video, I will put it up right here, and the mistakes you should avoid, definitely made mistakes. And I also got a spray tan for the first time, I think back in 2020, right before the pandemic in California. I will also put that video right here. So today I want us to just talk about that, is the experience and what to have to prepare for spray tanning and what to do afterwards, as this is probably my third or fourth time that I'm getting a spray tan, so I just want to share it. This is the afterwards, what I look like, and I went for the shade 3 of this sugar and bronze location, and that's the same place that I went to back in 2020 as well. This is not a sponsored video, but I just do like their services, and I also got recently complimentary service, and I also had the founder Courtney on my podcast. So if you want to learn about the business and learn about the what they do and everything, it's really cool experience and cool to get to know their story, so you can definitely go to my podcast. But without further ado, let's get started. First thing I would say, this is good for pretty much any sort of tanning. You should definitely exfoliate. If you have a dry skin like mine, I wouldn't necessarily recommend it, like a very harsh exfoliant, because you know it's gonna make your skin even drier. So use something very gentle. I used to use a lot like Clarins scrubs, and it's very good for me. But you can definitely use something else. But if you have like an oilier skin, it's more on that side. Definitely use something more stronger so that it can exfoliate more, because your skin needs to be out of all that, so it's like good for the new skin that you're going to have after the tanning. So second process, this is actually essentially part of the exfoliating, I would say, but it is shaving, trimming, and all the stuff that you would need. This is definitely different for guys, but for women, obviously, you know, there's so much that you need to go through, like the legs and everything else. But with guys also, I know that, like, you know, you should at least get your haircut beforehand, because you don't want to have, you know, if you're gonna get a fade and shit like that, you might have some tanning failures. So you want to get the haircut beforehand. You want to trim your armpits if you're doing that. You want to you know, do your face beforehand. You know, are you trimming it, or like, you know, you are leaving something on it? Just do it beforehand, so it's as small as possible that you want. It's up to you, and you can shave whatever else you wanted. One thing is that's different, that I guess with tanning beds, we'll talk about in another video. With tanning beds, I obviously, you know, no one is with you, just go into the machine so you can be completely naked. But with, you know, spray tan, you have to wear your underwear, so you need to make sure, so like your area down there is not gonna be a problem. So if you don't do anything with it, it's totally fine. So you don't have to go all in, but overall you should take care of that as well. So manscaping. There's a video on that too. Anyways, so yeah, after this process, I'm gonna just walk you guys through and insert some of the clips. So I went to the Sugar and Bronze Chelsea location. It was really, really cool. So walk in, you check in, then you can go to the bathroom if you need to, you know, use it. I actually went to the bathroom because I had like sunscreen, and I wasn't sure if it will affect or anything. She said it didn't, but I just washed out my face, and also want to show you guys the bathroom there. It was really cool. It was a great Malian photography and everything. Really gets you to the vibe of vacation and the beach vibes and everything. Then afterwards, you can go into your changing room and everything. I don't know in the other locations or other places. This one had like all these drawers with like the mask and like the thongs you need, or the flip flops. Like if you need it, you know, you can definitely use it. So obviously this goes more towards women, but in case you need something, like guys use a lot of stuff the same too. So in case you need it, then there's also a mirror that you can check yourself out. Then one thing they recommend, I'm so glad they tell you this, moisturize. You should obviously moisturize beforehand, but some of your dry areas, like your you know, elbows are right here, you can see like this part gets it dry most, or your knees, you should definitely apply moisturizer in those areas. So that's what the girl recommended to me. I'm also gonna walk you guys through the area that shows it, that like looks like a shower area, that it shows a formula and like the hose that they use to do it. So it's very simple, like really not bad at all. And like girl knows what they're doing, so they do it very quickly and efficiently. Then afterwards, you can actually still have the hose without the tan part, so that you can dry yourself out as much as you need to. Then afterwards, you can just put your clothes on and everything. One thing I would recommend is, like, wear definitely loose clothes that it's not super tight, because you're gonna have some sort of marks on your clothes, like some sort of tanning. So definitely remember that. Don't plan for any activity, anything like that. No gym, nothing like that, or even friends. Straight go to home. Make sure you don't sweat, because that's something that's gonna cause. Another thing I have noticed, and I didn't do it this time, is, like, I was crouching so much, and I had these, like, lines that I don't have anymore. So I would definitely recommend that, like, you don't do any sort of activity. So make sure, like, during that first 3 2 hours, that, like, limit that activity, so you stay as sculpted as possible. Essentially, think of that first 3 hours of your sculpting moment, and whatever you're going to get and whatever you keep it is going to stay like that. So because I got the shade 3, so the fourth is that max one, which is, like, darker. I honestly wish that I should have gotten darker, but another time maybe I will try. So for 3 hours, she said keep it. Then afterwards, you can wash it, and, like, even if you keep it longer, it's not gonna be any different. So after 3 hours, you can shower, but you don't use any sort of water, like any sort of what is it, body wash, anything like that. Just water, and you have to make sure that you guide the water through your hand, because water has, like, droplets, and, like, these, it goes like this, and it's going to have, it might have streaks, so make sure that you just guide it through with your hand, so it's smooth like this. It looks really, really good. I would definitely recommend that part. And then after 24 hours, obviously you can use moisturizer, you can use the body wash, anything you want. Any further thing that I would recommend is that, like, keeping the tan longer is obviously a process. You really have to make an effort for it. Moisturize longer, because, you know, our skin is like it changes the dead skin, or, like, any sort of skin. It's like our skin is always changing for seasons and everything. So more you moisturize, like, longer you're going to keep the tan that you will have. But obviously, it's gonna be dependent for a person. Obviously, more you shower and more you do other activities, faster it will go away. But I feel like in my case, it has been, like, the 2 weeks period that it's gonna be slowly fading away. But obviously, it can take longer. It really just depends how much you're going to be exposed. And one thing I would recommend that some people, I guess, don't take that into account. Just because you got a tan or spray tan anything, this doesn't protect you from the sunlight. So make sure to always use your sunscreen on your body, on your face, so that, like, you will still have the tanning that you will get, but it won't also, you know, hurt your skin, because tanning, any sort of tanning, is not going to give you protection from the UV lights or UVB lights. So just remember that. And these are all my tips for you to get your first spray tan if you are going for it, if it is your second or third time, but you wanted some tips as a refresher. This was the video for you. I hope you guys liked it. If you do, please don't forget to give a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys next week with another video. Bye, guys.